I'm Nick Cercone. I'm a computer scientist in the Department of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science here at York University. My research interests are primarily in computational linguistics and data analytics. As academics, we have primary responsibilities to both teach and to perform research. And as publicly supported employees, I think we also have some obligations to try to help economic benefits for our country. And combining all those does require common sense because there are different reward systems between academics, industry, and government, and balancing them is a difficult task, but not impossible. And we've had in the past, even 5 years of CIVDDD, great success working with private sector partners, introducing them to research, getting introduced to actually applied research, and finding outlets for students who eventually get jobs with these folks. Big data has changed the landscape because people talk about big data as though it's a panacea, but analyzing it is where the difficulty is. Originally, data mining was termed knowledge discovery in databases, where you found previously unknown, potentially useful information out of large databases and data warehouses. Nowadays, we're looking at streaming data, which is a different kind of phenomena. This is data that's coming in so fast, you don't have time to tuck it away, store it, and then apply standard data mining algorithms to it. You need to make some analysis on the fly, decide what to keep, what to throw away, and what you can analyze as it's coming in. Some examples might be if you had real-time traffic analysis of a city like Toronto, can you imagine how much streaming data there is from everywhere there's a camera looking at some street sign? Or if you were at a critical care hospital and you have a lot of patients who are looking at different blood indicators and vital signs that are being constantly reported through your cell phone back to the central feeding agency, that's streaming data. What are you going to do with all that? You don't have time to build a standard transaction data set like Walmart might have for their customers or the telephone company might have for their services. This is data that's basically coming in so fast. Or it could be unstructured data, like looking at Twitter feeds and blogs and all kinds of information out in the social media nowadays. And you want to know what the pulse is of the public who are engaged in this so you can make better business decisions, better demographic kind of decisions and things like that. So big data, I think, has now shifted from just massive amounts of data, but the kinds of data, the streaming data that needs to be analyzed. But high performance computing really deals more with trying to get as much bang for the buck as you can out of the compute engine. So things like BlueJeans that IBM makes, the largest computer in the world, those are high performance computing. Client server architectures, cloud architectures are a different kind of architecture where you can do some high performance computing, but they're optimized for different kinds of throughput. So It depends on what your end use is going to be. We have about two dozen different private sectors. Some are large, like IBM, IBM Platform in particular. Some have social redeeming features, like the Globe and Mail that we're working with. Some are small companies. They were startups maybe 30 years ago, like Empress Software out in Markham or Infobright downtown. Some of them look for health risk assessment, like manifold data mining or infrasystems. Some are fairly large, like Fuse Forward, that look at energy analytics. We have a whole range of them, and we're probably only at the beginning of building up a lot of those partnerships right now, even though we've engaged with some of them for about 5 or 6 years already. Stable, long-term relationships with private sector partners is really the way to move forward in research and development. And we do a bit of both, and I think it works out pretty well. The projects and how they're maturing and how they're having an effect and an impact on the private sector partners, I'm quite happy with that.